Hello everybody and welcome to another Jurassic World Evolution 2 video. And for today's, I want to discuss the trailer as well as some of the images that kind of reveal something the game might be giving us that not many people have noticed. Now, I want to first direct your attention to two things. One is the image of the Tyrannosaurus Rex on the banner for Jurassic World Evolution 2's Twitter account, which looks just like the regular T-Rex from the movies, I know. However, just pay attention to the arms, and they look proper, they're pronated and stuff, so that matches. However, what I want to discuss is how they are going to be possibly introducing paleo-accurate versions of the dinosaurs. Now, the reason why I think this is not just because of this image, but if we look at the other T-Rex image that Frontier has shared, or Jurassic World Evolution 2, it shows a similar T-Rex with some slight differences. The biggest one, which has suggest makes me think of this theory, is the arms. Now, on the one for their banner on Twitter, they're pronated. However, for this one, they aren't, which, if you know paleontology, you know that their arms are off to the side and not pronated like they are in the movies. Now, I'm thinking that maybe this is their way of telling us that we may be getting two versions of each dinosaur. Now, I know we'll probably get skin variants like they had in the original game. However, are they gonna possibly also introduce some paleo-accurate versions? Because this would be a very interesting thing to do. Because then it'd be cool to have both your regular Jurassic Park versions of dinosaurs and paleo-accurate versions. And this isn't the only time they've actually suggested this, as if we look in the trailer itself at the Nasutoceratops that was shown by the water near the end of the trailer, it shows it to be like the Battle of Big Rock one, which is pretty good and most people will like it there. However, an image that was shown of another Nasutoceratops that was orange and quite different actually, I think this could be another way they're showing that we will be getting paleo-accurate versions of dinosaurs. Now remember guys, it's just a theory, it may not happen, but I think that this is their way of telling us without actually just saying it in words, that we could be getting paleo-accurate versions, because like, remember, Jurassic World Dominion is going to have paleo-accurate dinosaurs for the first time in the franchise, as well as, of course, returning InGen variations of dinosaurs, / Maseranis. And is this going to happen with Evolution 2? Are we going to be able to see paleo-accurate versions? Because we know with the clip that is going to be showing with Fast 9 for Jurassic World Dominion, it's going to take place back in the Cretaceous period, 65 million years ago. And there we're going to see a paleo-accurate version of a T-Rex, at least according to the Jurassic World universe. So, is it possible that we're going to see them? I'm not sure, but maybe it is. But what do you guys think? Do you think that this is Frontier / Jurassic World Evolution's way of saying that, hey, for the sequel, we're going to have paleo-accurate versions as an option? Or do you think that this is just a mistake? Because it could just be a mistake, but I don't think it is. They wouldn't have that important of a mistake. And especially because if you also look at the heads of both the T-Rex and the Pseudoceratopses, they don't actually match. Like, especially with the T-Rex, the head is shaped differently, but this could just be me. What do you guys think? Leave in the comments if you think we're gonna get paleo-accurate dinosaurs in Jurassic World Evolution 2, as well as other skin variants for genetic modification purposes, of course. Because I think we actually have seen that already with the Triceratops, because we have two images of them, one of a green Triceratops and one of a sort of regular Jurassic World variant. But anyway guys, that is gonna have to wrap up this little theory video for Evolution 2. Hopefully we can have paleo-accurate versions, because it'd be really cool to see how different they are when they're next to each other. I'd love to see that, wouldn't you guys? But anyway, if you've enjoyed this video, I'd appreciate the like, and if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button to join the hunt as we get closer and closer to 1,000 subscribers. Be safe, and until next time, I'll see you later. Bye-bye!